Dan starts off this hour in Canada. Hey, Dan, how are you?
I'm better than I deserve. How about you?
Oh, just the same. What's up?
Well, I'm one of your financial master coaches, and I just wanted to get your opinion and see if my advice was right. I have a lady who is on disability, and the constraints of her disability say that she cannot have more than $3,000 in her savings account, and otherwise her disability payments decrease. She's gone through baby step two. She is currently renting, but she wants to own a house.
Uh-huh.
And
what is the nature of her disability?
I haven't been able to get that from her. She said it took her 3 years to qualify, and she is afraid to go off a disability because if she does and she has a relapse, she's going to wind up not being able to get back onto disability.
Yeah.
So basically, she can borrow as much money as she wants, and as long as she can pay it, and that's fine with the government. But if she has more than $3,000 in her savings account, then they start cutting her benefits.
Right.
So the thing is, she's got an insurance settlement coming in that will allow her to put a significant down payment on a house, and she's allowed under the disability rules to own a house, and then she can make the payments out of it. She wants to do a duplex and rent the other side, and she's allowed to have passive income. Mm-hmm. So my advice was to get the insurance company to pay the down payment, and then she uses the rental income to pay off her mortgage.
Yeah.
Which she could pay out of her disability payments as well.
How much is her disability income?
I couldn't. We just started talking, and I haven't got exactly the numbers.
Well, when I'm facing these things, what I look at is if they're trapped in the disability income, which is what we're describing, then we either have to say we're going to live our life on that income. Because the disability, the nature of the disability is so extreme that this is our income and we're going to make this the rest of our life because that's our only shot. And so we got to acquiesce and fall within these things.
Right.
Oftentimes, though, I find people who the nature of their disability allows them to have a different kind of a career that makes them a whole lot more than they would have gotten from disability. And I would rather them have an encore life here and, take another bow after the disability hit. Now, again, it depends on the nature of the disability. If someone is completely, in a situation where they can't do anything, then you got to just stick it out, right? But if it's, if they're facing like depression and they got declared disabled for that, then, hey, let's work to get rid, let's work with a good set of prescription drugs, with a good counselor, with a good doctor, and let's work our way through that. Lots of people do, and then go on to have fabulous careers. So, what I really would like for her to do is not be trapped in disability. I'd rather have an encore career where she makes three times as much money, and she can just go, I don't care what the government says, just drop the disability, let's go on. But she's fearful about that for some reason, and you've got to dig into that. So there's really no middle ground. You're not going to prosper with a limited income and a limited ability to save. And the government is ensuring that you are their slave at this point with this program. And or you can say, I'm going to cut the tether and we're going to go adrift and we're going to put this game plan together in order to be on our own. And those are really the only two ways you can get at this.